Well, everybody, this is a side of me that you normally don't get to see. We're downstairs in the what I call the Arctic foxhole or the bomb shelter. That's thus the hat. This space down here is where most of the important decisions with Rustin ice hockey are made. We're just going to give you a little tour of what's going on here. If we go over here to my left, this is my hat collection. These are the hats that mean the most to me over the years, and some football helmets from playing football as a kid. And then over here is my filing cabinet, where I keep the records of all of Rustin's ice hockey players and families and everything that's happened in the history of Rustin ice hockey. And over here is my library, the different coaching books I've read, the different symposiums that I've gone to, all the notes and binders of all the teams over the year. It's all right here and archived. There's some over here, right here. These are the boys' first pair of skates. Both Josh and Noah started with these pair of skates. Up here you have some of my team jackets. I have a lot of team jackets. This was my varsity letterman's jacket. This was when I was a head coach at East, Westchester East. This was when I worked for the Flyers. And then over there we have Westchester University. This is a really important piece of furniture in the bomb shelter. This is the chair that I sleep in when I'm watching game film all night. On this side of the room, what we have here is the Keystone State Games medals. I'm very proud of that. I've coached many, many years with the Keystones. These aren't all of them. Some of them are upstairs because you only get 20 medals. It's kind of like the old Olympics where the coaches don't get medals. So either players got them or I gave them to my sons. But I've won, you know, several bronze medals, several silvers as an assistant coach. But I've always won gold as a head coach. These are 3 gold, and I have 2 more upstairs for 5 gold medals. So that's kind of like the state Olympics. It's pretty cool. In every state, they have them. The Empire State Games, Garden State Games, and in Pennsylvania, it's Keystone State Games. And that's our jacket that we wore. It's a little dusty because I haven't coached in a few years there. Down here on the table, I'm pretty proud of a few things. This first picture over here on the left is of Brian Isola, who was one of my captains at Newman, who got nominated for the Hockey Humanitarian Award, which is the second highest award in college hockey besides the Hobie Baker. We went up to Buffalo for the Frozen Four, and he didn't win it. He came in second, but it was still a very proud moment for Newman. And then the picture over to the right is Jeff Marinari, who was my captain and assistant coach. And really, the Newman ice hockey program was founded on his shoulders. So I'm very proud of that, that day of graduation. Here we are on the other side of the bomb shelter. This jersey here is very special to me. This was my club team growing up. It's the Buffalo Regals. You can see Buffalo, New York. This is the equivalent to playing for the Junior Flyers, so I'm very proud of that. And that was the team I played for as a club team. Over here is the Coca-Cola Classic Shootout, Future Stars. This was a skills competition held by Coca-Cola when I was a teenager, and I got to participate in that, and that was pretty cool. That was like the punt, pass, and kick competition. So that's a very special jersey. All these jerseys are special. This is a Newman jersey, one of our captains, the picture I showed you in the other room. This is Jeff Marinari's jersey. It hangs in the Hall of Fame here. This is a Villanova jersey. I coached Villanova for 5 years, 2 as a head coach. I was at Newman for 6. At Westchester U, I was there for 6 years. This is an original Westchester U jersey. I think it was Mikey Sincata's. You can see the C on it. That's what makes me think that it was his, because he was our captain at the time. This is my high school jersey. I was the captain of my high school team. What's neat about this is a real old sweater. As you can see, the C is actually sewn on, and it's real material. So that's pretty cool there. That's old school. This was a benefit team I played on to raise money for the firefighters down in Delaware County when I was at Newman. It was against the Flyers alumni. That's one of the very few games that I've played in since I retired as a player. Over here we have a Westchester East jersey, coached at East for many years, 6 years, and won several championships. And then this jersey over here is when I played for the USA developmental team. Over here we have a couple things that are pretty cool. We have a couple of the pucks that are milestones in my career. We have my 150th win as a high school head coach. We have my 175th win as a high school coach and my 200th win. They all occurred at Rustin, which is pretty cool. My 100th win was at Westchester East. So 200 wins in 11 or 12 years is quite a lot of wins. It's a testament to the kids, not me, but you know, a lot of great teams and a lot of wins. Back here, this is where I watch a lot of my game film. This is my AV section, so to speak. I'm a little old school, so I still have a DVD player and VHS, but mostly DVD. And John Breznicky does a great job for me and does all my video and gets me everything I need to analyze our team and the other teams we play. And I couldn't do what I do without him. Over here is my sword. There's a sword in the trophy case that you saw when we did the Coach's Corner at Iceline. That's the Rustin sword. This is my personal sword, which is really cool. I use that to knight my captains. And then if we go over here to the other side of the room, I love this part of the room. My Toronto Maple Leafs pennant, that was given to me by Eric Knodel when he got drafted by the Maple Leafs. I hate the Maple Leafs, but I have to root for them now because if Eric plays there, that's one of my boys. And then this was my first Villanova team over here. That picture's taken at the stadium. And then this was my first Newman team. God, those guys went through heck. As you can see, there's a couple people in here that you might recognize from the other picture in the other room, like Jeff Marinari and et cetera. So this was my first Newman team. We're winding down now in the bomb shelter. This is the last wall we'll talk about. This here, the sailfish, is a gift from my father-in-law when he passed away. He caught it in the Gulf of Mexico. When I was at Newman, pretty funny story, the recruits would come into the office and they would meet the sailfish. Non-recruits or walk-ons, the players would say to them when they came to training camp, "Have you ever seen Coach Russo's fish?" And they always thought it was in a fish tank or a fish bowl. And they'd say, yeah. But they knew that this was the fish they were talking about, so they knew whether they were lying or not, which is pretty cool. I love the fish. Here we have our original score sheets from the Flyers Cup, our first Flyers Cup, and the state championship. They are the originals. This one's actually in blue ink, which is pretty cool. We were the last high school team, one of the last high school teams to play in the Spectrum. They tore it down right after that. And then the next year when we played for the state championship, we played in Mellon Arena. So right before they tore that down. So Rustin Ice Hockey was the only high school team to play in both arenas right before they tore them down. So these are really awesome. The name plates with all the guys' names on it, same thing here. And again, you can see all the original scribbles, which is really cool. This here is my team, the state championship team. They're all my team. I don't know what to say, but these are a really special bunch of guys. And, you know, this was just an awesome ride, and hopefully we can do it again this year. We got recognized by the school district here. This was from the school board recognizing our accomplishments. And this was up here, our record. And what a great team and a great season. Same picture, it's just a plaque. But all in all, Rustin Ice Hockey just keeps going. This is the original night. And that's where we're going to end tonight. As you can see, this one's gold. The one in my office is silver. And, you know, we've had many conversations. And this is the Rustin night.